laymen regard George Washington as a war hero, our first president. In reality, he was a simple man with simple desires. From an early age, he was most concerned with, in addition to popularity and notoriety, booty. And no, I do not speak of a pirate's loot, but rather the rear female rotunda. In addition, Washington was one of America's first celebrities. And just as in any other case, it is often hard to discern between what is fact and what is fiction.
You know, I heard G-Dubs is coming tonight.
Well, I heard he's going to be at the Prada party at the Bar Marmont's.
Hey, what do you think of this coat?
I like it. It's colonial pimp. Very G-Dubs.
You know, I heard George Washington
is dead sexy.
Is a real OG.
Bathes in crystal.
Is a two-timing bastard.
Gets blowjobs for breakfast.
Can never tell a lie.
What about that little number over there?
I don't know, Gus. I normally don't go for girls that look like Ernest Borgnine.
I take what I can get.
First time broke out a bone, a tread over my shoelaces. First time broke out a bone, a tread over my shoelaces. Over my shoelaces, yeah, over my shoelaces. Got to get a new pair of shoes to kick it with her, not kick it with you.
Washington did live the high life, partaking in a plethora of masquerades, shindigs, and kickbacks. But on a day-to-day basis, his life was rather mundane.
It's always good to have protection, because you never know where the day will take you. And you wouldn't want to end up like old Tommy Jefferson, where every girl who ever spread her legs for you ended up preggers.
Gus, where can we get us some cheap eats?
I know just the cantina, sir.
Gus, sir was my father. Call me G-Dubs.
Hola, ¿qué tal, señor? Yo quería un burrito de guacamole y una horchata también. Gracias, señor. I learned from an early age that the chicas were the way to go, so I picked up on a little of the Espanol, if you know what I mean. Gus, you never fail me. This is bitchin'.
No matter Washington's age, he exuded a kind of youthful vitality, approaching life with a childlike gusto. He transformed what would otherwise be boredom into wonder.
Shape it into a gear and then tell me your pain.
I don't think this is how it works. It's safer this way, just drive.
Washington was quite a Lothario. His promiscuity can be attributed to his desire to play the field. As a Don Juan, settling down was the last thing he wanted to do.
I don't think we should do this.
What do you mean?
Well, I don't know. I've heard a lot of stories. Your reputation precedes you. I mean, I'd hate to become another notch on your belt.
Come on, baby. Become a part of history.
Millions de Chinois, et moi, avec ma vie, mon petit schéma, mon mal de tête, mon poids au foie, j'y pense et puis j'oublie, c'est la vie.
And I said, never with an Armenian.
et moi, avec ma voiture et mon chien, son canigou quand il aboie, j'y pense et puis j'oublie.
Washington was also very concerned with how he was perceived by the masses. His vanity was one of his biggest emotional crutches.
You've seen my rides, you've seen my pool, you've seen my kitty cat. Oh, hey ladies. Now get the f*** out! Go!
While most bygone personalities with their stiff upper lips exist in black and white, Washington resides in a sort of mythological gray area. His image embodies the values and longings of a nation. He is the manifestation of our wants, of our doubts, and of our dreams. Washington is the mirror image of the country he founded.